What is up? It is the one and only loser. Hope you're having a great day because I am. And today we are continuing on Doom 3 BFG Edition. Part 18. Yeah, part 18. You're in Delta Labs 3. And there is Bald Man with two bodyguards. Yep, they destroyed that bridge.
Access granted.
What kind of walls are you hooked to?
Decontamination chamber sequence initiated.
Killed him. Uh-oh.
Oh, please, please.
Save your pee wee 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 from my chain gun bullets, but I guess he's a bit
dumb. Decontamination process started. Decontamination complete. Have a nice day.
You douchebag. You thought that was a good idea.
This is the personal audio log of Dr. Frank Serrato, dated September 19th, 2145. been brainstorming on Retriever's thoughts about achieving sustained, uninterrupted transfers from the teleportation units. Currently, our systems can only build enough of a charge to have the portals open for approximately 10 to 15 seconds. It's enough time to get a team through, not enough time to send in some of the heavier equipment. Engineering in the Inpro facility informed me that we can theoretically boost the active warp time to 45 seconds quite easily. But this will require rerouting power from central processing. We just can't afford the downtime. Power requirements for the system are astronomical. We're sucking power from three veins in Inpro just to power chamber one. I have no idea how we can sustain transfers for longer than 60 seconds without giving serious thought to reorganizing the teleport power grid. I'll sleep on this. This is Dr. Frank Serrano signing off.
Oh, okay.
Please select teleport destination. Pad 2 selected.
Okay.
Decontamination process started. Decontamination complete. Have a nice day.
My patience with you is wearing thin.
No one likes armor.
Look around you, Marine. Everyone is dead, and soon you will join them.
Access granted.
Whoops. God. Oh, damn it. Jesus.
Please select teleport destination. Pad 3 selected.
Teleportation on middle button.
decontamination chamber sequence initiated. Decontamination process started. Primary system failure. System shutdown. Backup systems online.
Stop him!
Maintenance personnel needed in chamber. Pad 2 selected.
This is the audio log of Dr. Martin Schultz, dated August 2145. We need to amend the operating procedures to ensure that all target teleport markers are properly set and locked before engaging the systems. We had a tragic accident today in Chamber 1 led to the death of Susan, one of our female chimps. She stepped onto the platform during the calibration phase, and an electrical short gauged the system, literally split her in two. The torso appeared at the destination marker, while her lower extremities remain in place on the source pad. I'm not sure how we've gone this long without this problem appearing sooner, but it seems like we've been having nothing but difficulties getting these systems to work. I don't know where Betruger finds the energy. He's been busy slaving away in the labs for 16 hours a day trying to debug these latest problems. What's he trying to do? Make the rest of his working sets look bad? Regardless, we have our work cut out for us over the next couple of days, going over all the systems logs to see exactly round of tests. Dr. Martin Schultz signing off, hoping to report better news next time.
Okay.
Pad 1 selected.
Progress, Marine, your journey is futile. You will die, and your soul will be mine.
What are you saying, dear? All right. That is it for Doom 3, Part 18. Peace out. Have a great night, and, I'll see you in part 19. Peace. Goodbye.